Who's? Did we send the invite out to him yet?
I have not sent an invite. Hold on.
I think the
mouse.
You okay over there? Are you pounding on the? Are you pounding something?
His mouse pounding.
Mouse pound.
I know.
Mouse.
No.
He was asleep. He said, "Give me a minute." So I don't know if he's going to, he's probably trying to get presentable right now.
Well, yeah, wake up a little bit.
Yeah.
I understand.
Splash a little something in your face, you know. I'm getting music ready. By the way, if you ever want to be on Why Am I Still Single, let us know. Got time to fill here as we send that Zoom invite out. Amar has been with us for how many years?
The way you said
almost
that,
three.
The way you said that sounded like he's been with us, like he's been born and like alive here on this planet.
We have been trying to get him, ladies, for a long time. If you remember, I'll take you back to a couple. First time we met him, he was super, we're talking about nervous.
Super uber nervous.
He really put himself out there. Like, he was really shy. So we gave him a secret code word. When you get nervous, we said, just say Mustang. And so he started to get nervous, and he started to put Mustang into every other. And we didn't come in and save him like we said we were going to. That wasn't even my favorite. My favorite was when we had him on in the second time, and we gave him the code word of help. When he felt like he needed help, just say help. And he abused that word.
Well, and he, with right, he abused it because our equipment wasn't working well, so we couldn't hear him say it, so we weren't even helping him.
We couldn't hear it.
We weren't helping.
But here's the thing, the growth from this man, he doesn't need help anymore. You do it all on his own, right, Amar? You've come so far, buddy.
Right. That's true. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Good morning. Did you get a haircut? It looks nice. Yeah.
Thank you. Yeah, I got the beard trim, all that good stuff.
I love Perfect. It. You look spiffy.
Just in time for tomorrow, Amar.
Oh, nice.
Now, have you heard us talk at all about, obviously, we don't want to go back, but we're going to for just a moment. The lady that we had planned for you last week, she got a little nervous and didn't come on, so we gave her your information. Has she called yet?
She has not called yet, no.
All right. Are you ready to move on from that, or do you want to still wait for her to call?
That's not a fair question.
Yeah, he doesn't.
Well, let me ask
you. That's not a fair question.
Why is it not a fair question?
Because there's nothing to cling on to right now for him. Like,
he doesn't know the full situation.
I'm about to tell him full situation.
I know, but you're asking him for an answer to something he doesn't have all the parts for. Like, he doesn't have all the clues yet.
Is your heart open to something else?
Yeah, my heart is open to something else right now.
That's a better question. Yes, there we go. That's what we need.
Do you know why we asked that question, Amar?
Why?
He doesn't know, guys.
Look at him, though. He's smiling like he might know. He's smiling like he has a clue. What do you think it is?
I think somebody else is interested in me. I don't know.
How would that make you feel?
It makes me feel really well, really good.
There is another one interested in you, Amar.
Yeah. Nice.
Yeah.
Woo. I love that smile he has. It's my favorite.
He said woo.
Woo.
What are you doing tomorrow morning, big boy?
Yeah, I don't have anything going on. I don't have anything going on tomorrow morning.
Perfect.
Would you be free for a Why Am I Still Single?
I'll be free.
Okay.
You'll need a blindfold.
And a sign.
All right.
And a sign, yeah. That says hot on one side and cold on the other.
Sounds good. I'll do that.
We don't need any secret code words anymore, do we, Mar?
Yeah, no.
You got it.
No, buddy. I'm way past that.
Well, we are so excited for you. Tomorrow morning, you'll be on the show with this mystery listener that we have who had. Did she reach out to us? All right.
It was a friend that set me up with this person, but then I directly contacted the person in question.
Yeah. So tomorrow morning, you'll meet her live on the air. Okay, Amar?
Nice. Sounds good.
All right, man. You take care. Have a great day today. And tomorrow, why am I still single with Amar and this woman that we have that is coming on the show?
We'll see. Sounds great. Take care, guys.
You bet, buddy. We'll see you in the morning, okay?
All right. See you in the morning. All right. Bye.
Gary Nelson and Johanna in the morning.
They wake me up.
And today's best country all day. Froggy 98.
Why?
Because I almost just said I love you.
Oh, no. You should have.
I almost said I love you.
Why would it not? Why would
I
you
don't
stop?
Know.
Why'd you stop on it?
I don't know. You know how many times I've almost said it to you guys?
I know. I almost said it to you too, I say.
Yeah. Oh, man. I'm getting too close.
What's wrong with that?
No, there's nothing wrong with it. You're right.
There
you
really is nothing wrong with it.
You're right. There's nothing wrong. Ouch. What are you laughing at? My face?
He's laughing at your face, I think.
I don't feel right. This shower hair ain't right for me.
Huh?
Did you get your necklaces unkinked?
Yeah, I got them all back on. Right, I have order back in business, boys. I lost my pearl one, though. I can't find it. And that's the most expensive one I have. So annoying.
What the hell is that?
Good team. Great seeing you all. Joanna, you make the other two look great. Thank you, Jack.
Jack, no kidding. It is not good without her in here.
I take it.
You should take it. I gave it to you.
I'll take it.
I think I'm the only one that ever says that.
You are. I take it extra from you.
He feels it, though.
You're my best friend. It's not true that you don't feel it?
It's not true that he's the only one that ever says
that.
Great
say that.
I will say this. When you say it to me, it is prompted by him. That material never gets old.
Did you hear his announcement this morning?
That he's getting rid of the chickens. Why are you getting everything rescued in your home?
Did you hear the joke at the end, though, he gave?
You were so funny.
I could not even.
It was an inside joke.
I couldn't
joke,
even
but it
say
was,
nothing else. Like, I was.
See, that's what's hard for me. I was like, is it that hysterical because it's inside only? But it was also, I think, it was a overall good joke,
I think,
too.
Overall, because she gets the crap
It
meat
was a solid joke.
Because she gets the crap meat, right?
Yeah, because dark meat is awful.
Right.
I like
But
the
there's
dark
another
meat.
Little hidden message within that.
All right.
Not anymore.
All right.
Yeah, I did not know that. Actually, I did know that.
So, Kyle, this one first, and then
it was so
this
funny.
One second.
Yeah, it was missing your laugh.
I was like laughing I so hard. I know. Listen, that's the first time a radio show has made me laugh, and if it wasn't myself.
What about my joke?
I'm just kidding.
My paid in dollar bill joke.
The
Do you hear that
joke
one?
Was good.
She didn't hear that one.
No, she
Which
wasn't
one?
He'd set me up. I don't even know what's coming out. A stripper.
Oh, I didn't hear this one.
At University of Texas football coach and his girlfriend, who's a stripper.
Hot.
She had, well, she's a stripper, I suppose. She probably is.
Yeah.
She has a support monkey.
Shut up.
Yeah, for real.
And I want a support monkey.
The monkey bit a kid.
Oh.
On Halloween. They came trick or treating.
To their house?
She had the monkey on the shoulder or whatever. Yeah. And it bit this kid.
What happened next?
I said, somebody's getting sued.
Now, what would you say?
I don't know. You guys didn't give me enough of the whole story.
That's enough.
I don't even know what's going
monkey
on.
Monkey
right
bit
now.
A kid. Somebody's getting sued.
Stripper's monkey. They're getting paid in $1 bills.
Okay. Yeah.
That's two good jokes, man. The 6 o'clock hour.
Whoa. Jesus Christ.
Alexis, I believe it when I see it. She says Yellowstone in 4 days. Don't they keep extending
keep
that?
Saying it's coming out. It's coming out. Oh, I almost died, and you saved my life.
Did he catch you?
Yeah, he caught me.
He did. Did he put down the food first? He did.
I did, yeah. This is a good bagel, even though I don't have anything to spread on it.
What?
Who's going on a coffee run? Right-handed.
I don't ever forget. Like.
Damn it. She's got the coughs real bad. I don't like it. I bet it's a support monkey, LOL. Ah. I just started Yellowstone last night. I've been up all night watching it. Season one, LOL.
Our first person is in the waiting room.
Okay. I've been watching out. Still how new to get a hold of you through next. I have been watching, but still new how to get a hold of you through text. Ruth, are you new? Raw, I don't even know. You can just comment here. Yeah. Yep. Yep. Thank you, ma'am. Oh, is that who it is? Good team seeing y'all. Johanna, make your mother look great.
Make your mother? What do you think?
Rot and yes.
Gary, how's jujitsu going?
Why you ask? Oh, David asks. David, not bad. My ears are still a little tender. And I've not been since Friday. I'm going to go today. Huh?
Never mind. Nothing doesn't matter.
Gary, did you watch the World Series last night? Hip, hip.
Jorge.
Who's Jorge?
I don't know, but it sounds like something my husband said.
I did not watch it. I watched a little bit of it.
Why don't people ask me?
Johanna was disappointed in her husband's reaction.
I was.
Think he'd come on later to talk about it. We'll probably find time for him if he wants.
No.
You say no.
I don't really care, but... What? Why are you laughing?
I just laughed. Because it used to be like a big, like, oh, I don't know.
Oh, no, I don't care now.
The Royals traded him last year.
That's why you should know.
I gave up on Royals.
I gave up on the Royals.
Have a great day, guys. Kyle Matthews, here's your reminder. What's
reminder
that for?
What? Guys, it's for me. And me only, okay?
All right.
Sounds...
But Kylie said she's willing to be on Know Your Listener one day, so...
Next week?
Yep.
Let's book you next week,
you
Kylie.
You got secrets with our listeners, Kaka?
Yeah, we were messaging last night.
Uh-oh.
Hmm.
Get a man in trouble.
Get a man in
trouble. Gotta get a man in trouble for sure. Well, not... Huh, Nelly?
Nelly gets in trouble for that?
I don't get in trouble for nothing.
I'm into these old dad socks now, I think. Is that a good look?
Let me see. I don't find a problem with that at all.
It's my new thing.
Is that not a good look?
I think it's cool.
I think it looks fine. I guess skin ankles would be better.
I don't want skin ankles. It's cold out. Trina, what's your favorite cartoon? Isaac, I like Scooby-Doo. I don't know.
No,
SpongeBob.
Cam's keyword.
Hey, this is Cam Jurgens. If you want to see me and the boys this weekend, here's a chance to win a pair of tickets to the Nebraska game. Today's keyword is Devaney.
Enter that keyword at froggy981.com, and you could win tickets to this week's Husker home game with advanced medical imaging and Froggy 98. The Tracy's Collision Cam is live. Search Frog Mornings on YouTube.
Hey, don't forget on Saturday, too, we're going to be out of Buds of Billy's, in between Buds of Billy's and Brewski's for a big tailgate party. Starting at 8 o'clock on Saturday for the 11 a.m. kickoff at Ohio State. Time for Know Your Listener. This is where we bring a listener on. It's a mystery listener. We ask them some questions and then try to guess things about them. Who are they most like on the show? Are they average or athletic? And then finally, what is their level of education? Those three things. I believe we have our listener set and ready to go. Are you there? Can you hear us?
I can.
How are you?
Doing good.
Awesome. We're going to put 60 seconds on the clock and ask you some questions, okay? Is everybody set? Johanna, do you have a question?
Yep.
All right. Let's see here. Okay, your 60 seconds start right now. Okay.
The game begins in 3, 2, 1.
Now, the reason I ask this question is because something that Johanna is wearing that I don't know that anybody has picked up on yet. I did. Have you ever been to Chicago?
No.
Would you like to go sometime? Ever dreamt of it?
Hopefully someday.
Okay. Hopefully someday.
You are so naughty.
No, you're naughty.
Mystery listener, can you name it 3 athletic wear brands?
Oh. Yes.
Name them.
Nike, Under Armour, and Adidas.
Okay. Nice. Okay. Okay.
Mystery listener, what is an RA?
I don't know.
Don't know what an RA is. Do they have those in community college? I guess they do, don't they?
No. If you have, well, if you got
depends.
A dorm.
Yeah, depends. Okay, answers are all locked in. Let's think about this for a moment. Was that just an accident you wore that shirt today? I mean, you helped me with a question.
What are you talking about?
The shirt you have on right now. What does your shirt say?
It says Chicago.
Why? What do I always say about Chicago?
Can I say something? This shirt called to me yesterday in a store.
You just bought that shirt. You just bought that shirt.
Money on a dig.
Dang. I spent $16 on a dig.
You just bought that shirt.
I spent $16 on a dig.
I always tell you that you're talented. I always tell you that you're talented enough to work in Chicago.
Oh, man.
They sent it to me. That's what I...
Chicago sent it to you. The city.
The city.
Came with the contracts.
Where he's saying the dig is that he's always wanted to work there.
I've almost worked in Chicago.
Twice.
Wait, listen.
Guess what? You haven't struck out 3 times. That's when you're out. You got one more at you.
Yeah, I'm not going to lie. I feel like I got a little bit closer than you because I literally walked by. Why did this happen to me? I was in a store not looking for clothes for me at all. I walked by and the table was like, Chicago.
I'm going to lock in. You said that you have never been to Chicago. Nelson has. And that you kind of have dreamt about going there. Joanna, have you been to Chicago?
No, I've driven through, but I've never, done anything there.
I'm going to say that you're most like Johanna on the show. Locking in, Johanna, average athletic.
Oh, this is hard because she picked the 3 brands that are pretty, normal ones, you know?
Yeah, mm-hmm. But she answered them, you know?
She didn't answer them. I'll say athletic.
All right.
Didn't know what a resident advisor was. An RA. Mm-hmm. Now, could that mean that she went to college, like Gary had suggested, perhaps a community college that didn't have any campus living? Did she just go to college and live at her parents' house so she wasn't in the dorms? I'm going to say you have an associate's degree.
Lock it in? Mm-hmm. All right, mystery listener, go ahead and show yourself on the Tracy's Collision Cam. Hello there.
Hi,
what's your name?
Brittany.
I'm sorry, Courtney or Brittany?
Brittany.
Brittany, I said you're most like Johanna on the show. How would you say? Would you say that's right or wrong?
I would say that's right.
I love it.
Can I ask you, did you get the Chicago, all of that stuff we were just talking about? Have you heard us talk about that on the air?
No, I don't think I really caught on to that.
Yeah, see? Just subtle. That's just subtle stuff there.
Yeah. Just personal attack.
Personal attack.
We can get into it later, but it's a double personal attack. You attacked personally first, and then... Yeah. Anyway.
Average athletic, Johanna.
I said athletic.
What do you think?
I'm not athletic.
Average. Come on now. What is the last athletic thing that you did? Did you like...
Oh, my gosh, that was so funny.
She looked over her shoulder.
Okay, yeah. Nothing, never.
Okay.
Good question.
All right, we're 1 for 2 so far. Nelson, the education stuff.
I said you have an associate's degree.
I will actually graduate in December with my bachelor's.
No way.
Dang it.
And so did you live in a, Brittany, did you live in a dorm?
I did not. I lived off campus my entire schooling.
There you go. Well, we're one for three this morning. Brittany, how long have you been a listener of the show?
Oh, man. For a long time. I was actually on your guys' show, Claire, back when you guys did like the Hungry Games right at Thanksgiving time.
Yeah.
Yeah. And we'll never eat pumpkin pie again.
We need to bring that back.
The Hungry
Games. The Hungry Games. That was hilarious.
Yeah, I wasn't there for that.
Yeah. You had to eat quite a bit of it, I suppose, huh?
Yep. Not.
I think you're athletic. I think you need to go back and say that you're athletic.
All right, Brittany. Hey, thank you for being on the show. We appreciate you. Have a great day today, okay?
Thanks.
All right, we'll see you later. Another Know Your Listener guest when we come back in a minute.
Funny, questionable, part of your...
I had no idea that you bought that shirt yesterday.
Yeah. I was at a store. I sent you a picture of it at a store.
I didn't know that.
How did you not know?
I thought you just, I don't know. I guess, I don't know. I don't know. I don't know.
Listen, and also let's talk about what is going on with clothing at Target. Like, what is this? This was in the women's section, like a cute shirt, and this is a size small. What is happening?
That's a small.
What? No. Yes. But well, how and why?
That shows you how small you are.
No, it does not.
You're size negative something. You know what? I think you got to wash. I bet that thing will shrink right up.
I hope so. Yeah. It's like it's a confusing shape. I don't know what's happening.
Yeah.
But I gotta wear it more than once, you know, to make it worth the money. So
God dang it. That is really funny. That is really funny. I saw the humor.
Why couldn't you just let it go? You had to point it out. Why couldn't you just let it go?
Needed a question.
You could have used a question and asked anything.
I don't think he would have realized. I don't think anybody would have picked up on it. You can't hardly even see it on the camera.
I did a couple of these.
You did?
Yeah, kind of.
You got to dance or sing or what's that? Isn't there a musical named Chicago?
Is there?
Is it a play?
Wow.
No, yeah, there is. Yeah, there is. There's a movie about it. It's a play.
Yeah. That's weird. I kind of remember that, but not really. I need another question. I can't think.
Yeah, and for Johanna to spend money on just a dig is big. That's a big thing, Sylvania says. That is, man. That is really love for your craft. You know what I mean? That is love for your craft.
It just felt meant to be. You know what I mean?
I think
like,
so.
I couldn't believe that I, like, walked by a table and it was, like, right there.
Right there. Flashing lights right in front of you.
Yeah. Yeah, it is. It's either mini or oversized. I know.
It's literally close.
We know.
Everything's supposed to be wide and short.
But this is also confusing because it does. It like almost looks like Chicago Bulls, but it's not.
That's not Chicago Bulls.
No, it's not. But what is it? Why would you make a shirt? Why is this fashionable?
I have no idea. Everybody wants to go to Chicago, I suppose.
I guess. Maybe it was just one shirt they made for me.
Maybe.
But on the table.
Now, it's just the Gary and Johanna show today. Nelson, so mad, being silent. He's just
there
silent.
There is
that's
nothing
all.
To be mad about with this.
He's just silent today.
Why silent?
The question is, if you'd had it.
I'm just sitting here taking digs to the freaking face.
You're not taking digs to the face.
Oh, my God.
These are body shots.
One tiny, tiny dig, which is ultimately a dig on us.
Yeah.
I don't even want to hear it. I've talked to many people about this because it makes me not happy. But you know what? You're the one who is allowed to be upset about it.
I'm not allowed to be upset about you guys throwing
in
my
face. I said you are allowed to be upset.
That was not a failure.
Your biggest failure is like saying that we are your biggest failure. Our show is your biggest failure.
No.
That's what it said. That's what it says to me.
That's not what it says.
The funny thing is that's what you do all the time. Well, it doesn't matter. That's how I feel about it. So I get to feel this way. And then now I'm saying that to you. Well, that's how it makes me feel. And you're like, well, that's not how it is.
Especially since all of this happened before you came here anyway. So you have nothing to, it has nothing to do with you.
That's more me.
Like, it has nothing to do with you. You weren't around for any of it.
Y'all stop talking about Chicago. Anyway, you're looking at it the wrong way, so it don't matter. It's not a failure, it's a success. If you make it far, you top four or whatever you said, that's a success. We didn't win the national championship my senior year. Made it to the semis. That's a success. When you say so, Joe.
I feel like our show is a success.
Our show is a success.
I feel like we're a good show. We're a fun show. We're a great show. This is success to me.
I think we're good enough to be in Chicago.
I do, too. I wouldn't leave you, boys. I'm just saying that.
You wouldn't leave us?
No, I wouldn't leave you.
I'd have a hard time staying. I'd have a hard time staying.
Yourself, if they offered you a job?
Yeah.
What he's saying, yeah.
Well, I mean, think about it. In a major, major market like that.
I don't know what it would be like. See, maybe I'm just really ignorant because this is the only radio I've ever done in my life.
I think I would say, okay, I'll take it. But got to bring my buddies, first of all. Secondly, I want to work from Lincoln, Nebraska.
Yeah.
I don't want to move.
I would What's do that, too.
So that's a nice little backpedal. I think I would take it. But I got to invite my buddies.
Got to take my buddies, guys.
The family affair.
Nanelli would leave in the middle of the night. Wouldn't even tell nobody.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. And he'd tell him how, and he would make fun of us the whole time he was in his own new show. I guarantee it.
Not accurate.
This is just real radio, guys. You know what I'm saying? Real radio right here.
Christina's talking about the dresses at Target. I do not understand the peasant dresses. Someone make it make sense to me. I will never wear a peasant dress.
Hey, are...
She good. She ready. Oh, she coming is. In.
But in the major markets, you guys have way more listeners that may hate you, too.
That's a good point.
Oh, man, you would have some for real stalkers. You know what I mean, Johanna?
Oh, man.
I mean the real ones. Not these fake ones.
Do you think my stalkers are fake?
No, they're not, but they're not like...
No, they're not harmful, really. Yeah.
No, I don't mean harmful either, but I mean like the ones that would like have your pictures up all over their rooms. You know what I mean? Like
I'm here for that. That the picture thing is fine. Just don't tell me about it. I don't want to know.
Oh my God. I gotta have a question here. Let me think.
Oh, I do too. I need an athletic versus average. Let's think.
Let's see. We just dug on Nelson. I dug on me with Thrush. What's a dig on Joe?
Dig me. I love it. Dig me.
Let me dig in you here.
It's not much to find, you know?
Yeah, not much to find.
I'm just kidding. Yeah, I know. There's lots of fun. I'm just joking.
Oh, just something
I can't think about you. I got to think about my own self.
This isn't even a dig. This is me actually trying to find...
I need really average. What?
Athletic. Come on. What mouse do I use?
Amar? Okay. Amar giving me a question.
That is a good one.
Listen to your favorite morning show on the Tracy's Collision Cam.
Every morning.
Just head over to Facebook. Facebook.com/Froggy981. Yeah.
Know your listener. Time for another listener to join the show. This is a mystery listener. We can't see their face. We can only hear their voice, just as you. At the end of this, we'll bring them live on the Tracy's Collision Cam so we can all see them. We're going to try to figure out who they're most like on the show, are they average or athletic, and what their education is, the education level. This is just our way of getting to know you a little bit more, and to thank you for listening. Is our mystery listener there? Yep, bringing him on now. Mystery listener, can you hear us?
Yes.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Are you ready to play our little game here?
Sure thing.
Okay, we're going to put 60 seconds on the clock. Here we go.
The game begins in 3, 2, 1.
This is not a dig on any of us.
Is that how you're going to preface everything now?
Mystery listener, have you ever cried at work?
Oh.
Oh. Because of work or because of life?
Or because of people that you work with?
I'm going to say because of work, not life.
No.
Never. All right.
Mystery listener, have you ever taken pre-workout?
Yes.
You have. Do women? I thought that was more of a man's
market. Love pre-workout.
You don't take pre-workout?
Yes, pre-workout's the best, especially just in life. Sometimes I take it not pre-working out. Just,
are you kidding me?
Yeah, it's like crap.
Women need the extra energy sometimes.
Yes.
We like get up with a lot.
Yes, exactly.
Wow, I had no idea.
My day is a workout, okay? Me getting out of my bed is a workout. I'm going to pre that stuff.
Nelly?
Mystery listener, what does length times width find?
Height?
Length times width. Equals height, she says. Lock it in.
Nope. Equals area. I don't know.
All right. Think about this for a minute. You never cried at work, you said. Because of work. Yep. Maybe you cried because of life at work?
Oh, yeah. Once in a while.
I was just curious. That doesn't count.
I've never cried because of life at work. I cry because of you at work.
I know, that's what I'm saying. That's why I say that answer doesn't count. You cried. I made you cry, and I never felt so terrible in my life. It was an accident. Whole thing was an accident.
Yeah.
But you did. You cried.
I did cry.
Have you ever cried, Nelson, because of work?
Not because of work.
No, because of life.
But yeah. I've cried because of life here.
At work.
Yes.
Yeah.
Interesting. On the air.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you have. Man. I'm just going to say that you're... like Johanna, because of the pre-workout, too, I think, because she does that.
Yeah. Okay, I'm going to say athletic, because you take pre-workout, even if you take it like me.
Yeah.
Which is not always to work out.
You ended up with the right answer. It was area.
She stumbled across it, didn't she?
She stumbled across it. I don't know, it gives me the feeling of some college. Like, you went to college, but you didn't quite finish that degree.
Didn't pay attention.
That's what I'm going to guess.
Late nights. Partying too much. So you say some college?
Some college.
Show your face, mystery listener. Let's see you. Hey.
Hey.
Now, wait a minute.
Look at that little baby babe.
Tell everybody your name.
Chelsea Nichols.
Chelsea used to work at the radio station.
No way. Yep.
Wait, how many years ago was that, Chelsea?
11.
Oh my goodness.
You don't know. I've worked here way too long.
Wow.
No. I've only been here for 10.
You guys have never met?
No.
You like her. She was crazy back in the day.
She was crazy.
Not much has changed except for this.
She's holding a baby.
She has a baby on her shoulder. Chelsea, do you listen to the show?
I do. Not every morning, but when I can, when I'm not running wild with this one. He's pretty mellow this morning, so
okay.
When I'm able to, I do.
Well, I said you're most like Johanna. Would you agree with that?
I feel like, yeah. We have a lot in common, I think. I've never met her, but yes, I think so.
Yeah.
I love it.
All right.
I said athletic. I stand by that, so.
Yeah. I like to consider myself athletic.
Yeah, you've done a lot of stuff, right? You play volleyball and stuff, right?
Yep.
Yeah.
Right.
Yes, sir.
So I suppose you completed the bachelor's degree, didn't you?
No.
Oh,
you
nice.
Yes. I have an associate's degree, but I'm very proud of it. I earned it.
That's all right. I didn't guess associate's degree. I only guessed some college, so I don't know that we get that one.
No, I don't think we do get that one.
Oh, darn it.
Although an associate's degree does feel like some college, because that's what I have.
That is some college, but it's a completion
it's
of some college. Yeah.
They say it's complete, sure.
Yeah, yeah. So, Chelsea, what are you doing these days?
I work at State Farm. I've been there for 8 years. I'm in western Nebraska. I'm out in Bridgeport. So
gotcha.
Across the state.
And how fun is the insurance business to be in?
I enjoy helping people, so it's a blast.
Well, we're glad that you can catch the show when you can, and we miss you around here.
Miss you guys, too.
Yeah, is that your only baby that you have that you're holding there?
I have a 17-year-old daughter, stepdaughter, and then, yes, a 2-month-old baby.
Wow.
Nice. Wow. Busy.
Yeah. Absolutely. Yeah. All right. Well, you take care of yourself, Chelsea. All right. Thanks for coming on the show. We appreciate it.
Yep.
All right. We'll see you later. Bye. It's 7:56 now.
The Tracy's Collision Cam is on.
I have not seen her in years. Did you book that, Nelly?
Yeah. I had no idea.
Well, you, why would you? You weren't here when she was here.
Right.
What's up, Kyle? You say something.
I am humped.
You're humped.
Isn't it humped?
Humped.
Like H-M-P-H?
I've never did that. Is that you do that in a text? Humped.
You're adding a T to it. Feels like.
I don't know. I'd say I'd never done it before. Humph.
My favorite thing from yesterday was you saying private C.
Private I didn't hear him say private C. When was
you laughed, I think.
I did. I laughed and I made fun of him.
I think
private C.
Private.
I don't remember that.
What's that, Kyle?
When you guys were talking about Jessica Simpson.
Ooh. Was it that? When? Oh, I didn't.
I go bathroom.
Go potty. Kyle's really quiet today. LOL.
Kyle's quiet. What's that?
Marge just said that. I don't know.
My mic isn't on all the time.
Yeah, oh, Gary shuts him off. Gary shuts him off.
Gary controls my life.
Good morning, Stacey.
Hi, Kyle. How are you? Says Amar.
Amar, I'm doing well. Haircut looks good. It's nice seeing you on Saturday. Hope you're having a good
week. I got Frankie's haircut yesterday. He's normal now.
Professional cut or you do it yourself?
A professional cut. I would never do a professional cut myself.
You just shave his head.
It was kind of embarrassing bringing him in and having to show a hairstylist, like, this is, I did this. Like, it looks like my kid cut his own hair. And then I was, like, asking someone to fix it. Nope, I just did it for Halloween.
That's dedication.
I know. I need a cough drop.
Don't you have a big bag of them?
I don't know what I did with them. It's like I set them down somewhere and I can't find. Oh, I got to...
Never leave me when you make me so happy with the rest of my life. Make me your way, will you make me your wife?
I gotta know.
Before we go any further, do you love me? Will you love me forever?
Oh, man. Johanna, are you going to the game on Saturday?
Yeah.
Yeah? Are you going, Nelson?
I'm not going to go to the game.
What am I saying?
Yeah. I just started working on Saturday so I could come down and see you guys downtown, AJ says. I think one of my favorite Meatloaf songs is... No, that's not Meatloaf.
What?
Minute, yeah, it is.
What?
Now, hang on, what is it?
I would do anything for love.
I always watched that video when I was in high school because of the girl in it.
She was hot.
But she wasn't even she didn't even sing, did she? Like, no. She was
Oh, I thought she had a couple of lines.
She did, but that wasn't the actual singer.
Oh, I did not know that.
Yes.
Yeah.
But I won't do that.
Yeah, that's a great song. But what won't he do?
It says it's in the song, but he said that because of the way the guy, he didn't write the song, but the way the guy writes the song, it's confusing as to what he won't do. So right before he goes into each chorus, he tells you what he'll do anything for love, but he won't do that. So
I'll do it all. I'll do everything.
Except for that.
But what's that?
Got to be dirty.
Hold on. It's in.
I won't do the dirty thing?
The dirty, dirty, dirty. You know what I mean?
The sex?
No, not that. Like the extras, the stuff.
What? Just watch this on TikTok. Meatloaf explaining.
What's the extras?
I don't know. There's got to be something that you won't do.
Yeah, it's in the song.
I don't know, man.
You do it all, you say. You just trying to get viewers.
Yeah, I do it all.
You can get me more. Mm-hmm. This can be my third cup, yeah.
Will you get me a cup, please?
You want a cup? You please. Want a little guy?
I'll take a little guy.
You want a little guy?
I don't want to sit. I'm not filling your big cup.
I didn't ask you to fill my big cup.
Are you guys back on? Are you guys back together now?
What?
You two.
I was never apart.
Okay.
I'll never forget the way you feel right now. He won't do that.
He won't do what?
I'll never forget the way you feel right now. That's what he won't do. He'll
never forget it again. The way
he's
you feel
never
right
going
to
forget the way you
That's
feel
lame.
Right now. There's like five of them. Hold on.
That's pretty lame, I'd say.
Ooh.
Have you guys talked about Friday yet?
Never forgive myself if we don't go all the way tonight. He'll do anything for love.
Why would he not forgive himself?
I don't know.
That means that he's the one that's holding back. He's withholding. What are you talking to yourself? I saw you. What conversation were you having? I have conversations with myself all the time. You do?
Yeah.
Thank you. Are you sure you didn't? You don't know which one's mine. She doesn't know which one's mine.
Because she introduced the third one.
And she got deep voice over here. I do not need to get sick. Went to Scooter's Coffee yesterday, then got a sticker, then crap, and slept all day. What'd she say? Oh. Then slept. Oh, then got sicker than crap and slept all day, etc. But I got up today to watch y'all. Thank you for it, Christopher Kelso. Thanks, Joanna. You'd pour me a new one because you didn't know which one it was.
No. Mm. You didn't throw that other cup away, did you?
Why would you drink it?
Yeah, I don't care.
Not knowing if she...
I don't care.
You don't care.
What? I said you didn't throw that other cup out, did you?
No, I'm right here. This one is... I put my lips on it, and I think I have a cold.
You lipped it.
Oh, I'll drink it.
You'll still drink it?
Listen to me. Will you guys just rasp, listen to her.
I don't care.
He would do anything for a deep voice.
Oh. You want this?
No.
Would you not do anything for a deep voice?
Yeah,
like,
but...
I cackle when I laugh right now.
I would, purposely make myself sick to get a deep voice.
You smoked cigarettes to get a deep voice.
Yeah, but that was also when I was young.
You should vape. I heard that that's really dangerous.
Oh, I guess vaping is out of control right now.
Out of control.
That's what I hear, man.
I feel like vaping was out of control a long time ago.
Out of control.
They're just now reading the articles. It's you guys, have you heard about this thing called vaping?
It's so bad. It's so bad right now.
I just watched this video about this guy who, because he vapes so much, he has to sleep upside down. Because if he doesn't, he'll swallow his tongue. Because
he vapes too much?
He did vape too much. But I was thinking about it. I wanted to comment on the video and say, sir, please show me how you sleep, because I don't understand. Do they have to hold his ankles up?
Yeah, is he in a,
But then how do you not?
Good for your back.
But then do you have to wake up every few hours so you don't die because all the blood would rush to your head, would it not?
You would think.
I don't know.
No,
let's ask Batman.
How do you swallow your tongue? Have you guys ever tried? Try right now.
My aunt died that way.
How? It's connected.
On TikTok, she had a seizure. They can put their tongue all the way in the back.
I think you'd have to cut that little connector.
She had a seizure. So what happens is it's a muscle. So if your muscle is spazzing and you can't control it.
But it's connected. That little deal.
I don't know. Maybe not all people's are connected.
Maybe it stretches or it tears.
I got a pretty good connector right now.
I don't know. I'm telling you this much. My Aunt Wanda died from swallowing her tongue. That's what I heard. That's the story I was told.
That's what they told you.
She lived with me, so I would think.
They don't want you to know the truth.
You think that's it?
What up, Tim? What? Found out yesterday the fish in the dark has very little to do with fishing?
What?
What?
I don't know.
People choke on their tongues. Yeah, they do.
People choke on their tongues.
Can't be good for head rush, Mandy says. I just don't see how you can choke on your tongue, guys. That's all I'm saying.
What did you say about fishing?
I don't know. I really don't want to get into what songs mean. That's why I wish I wouldn't have read it.
Oh.
I feel like you could. I think
Swallow your tongue? You got a long one, though. Yeah. I think yours could fold back. Mine's too fat. My God. You folded it.
You can't fold
your
tongue.
How the hell? You folded like a suitcase. Did you see that?
No.
Look, it folded over.
Yeah, that's a lot of tongue.
Can you do that?
No.
No, nobody can.
Not like you. I can fold my tongue in half, but not
Let
you.
Me see.
You fold yours flat and stick it out.
Let me see you fold it in half. You got to stick it out.
I can't
see it.
I can't. That's what I'm saying. I can't look.
No, I don't count.
It doesn't stick out like hers does. It's not.
Yeah, I don't count.
But I can flip my tongue back on top of itself.
You have a long tongue. I didn't touch my nose.
People choke on you all the time.
What?
That's what it says.
On who?
On you.
Not on me. It'd be on one of you two. It has nothing to do. I don't have that. I'm crying a little.
Oh my god. You guys are so funny, man.
That's so funny, man.
How'd you park this morning?
I don't know.
I was worried about you when I saw the big old how I parked. You got 1 minute. We got 49 seconds.
She says it's fine.
Just trying to get out there before Penthouse Amy rolls in. That's not bad.
No. Okay. Well, this is what was good for me. Is that other people were already parked, so I had to park between people.
Oh, that helps.
Yeah.
That helps for shizzle. For shizzle.
For shizzle my nizzle.
Single. Who's single? Leslie, you single? Can any of you touch your tongue to your nose? Joe Hanna can. I love chasing after you.
Nelson and Johanna are live on the Tracy's Collision Cam. Listen now on Facebook. Facebook.com/Froggy981.
If you want to see Walker Hayes, he's the guy that sings Fancy Like. His Fancy Like tour is coming. Ralston Arena, Saturday, February the 5th. Tickets on sale Friday, 9 o'clock. We have a pre-sale code for you that starts tomorrow morning at 9 o'clock. In the morning. 90s country is the code.
You can nice.
Also, yeah, you can also go to our Facebook page, Froggy981, and you can leave a comment and try to win tickets. Be listening for your chance to win them. How you doing with this, Johanna?
Doing with what?
A week from Thursday.
I don't know what you're talking about.
I don't even know
Wednesday.
What a week from Thursday is.
I think it's a week from Thursday.
Oh, yeah. That's so crazy it's that close. Oh, I'm going to puke. Why would you tell me? Honestly, what I'm doing with it is I'm pretending it's not happening.
Johanna turns 30.
I do.
In a week. Yeah, it is a week from tomorrow. Yeah. We're going to do birthday week next week.
You're going to do birthday week? Yeah. My husband should be praising me right now because... In the years past, I say I have birthday month. I've always said that.
Yeah.
All month, it is celebrate Johanna. November means I get whatever I want all month long. And I've always been that way. And this year, I'm like, just leave me alone. You I don't even want to talk about it.
You don't want it.
No. No, because, you know, I can't get it out of my head what I told you guys the other day. Like, if a newspaper headline, girl in her 20s dies, girl, 28-year-old woman, whatever, dies. That's sad. That's young. That's too young to die.
Yeah.
Now if I die, woman in her 30s dies. Nobody cares.
They still do.
No. They care less.
Not
they
as
care
much.
Less.
They I definitely feel... don't say girl.
No, they don't say girl in her 30s.
It's not a 32-year-old girl or a 30-year-old girl. It's a 30-year-old woman.
That's what I'm saying.
Perishes.
It's all downhill from here.
Well, what would you say was the highlight of the
my
last
life?
Decade? No, the 20s. What are you going to miss the most?
I don't know.
Just being crazy and fun and irresponsible?
I don't really miss that a lot, though. Like I had some really fun times for sure, but, like, I don't sit here and think, like, man, I wish I was still doing all those things. I don't feel that way.
You don't miss anything.
Which I'm thankful for.
Well, then you're ready for the next one. You're never ready for the next step, then.
I can do the next step and stay in my 20s.
Can't.
Why do I got to be 30?
Not possible.
Nope.
I don't know. I think I'm, you know what, I will say this. I remember talking to someone older than me, like a woman. I can't even remember.
Not a girl.
Yeah. But she said that in her 30s, she really felt like she found like confidence, like really like a lot of confidence. You know what I mean?
And yeah, my ex-wife found so much confidence, she left.
Yeah.
Well, so sad, just imagine the awakening you could have in your 30s.
Well, maybe.
You do. You come awake. Yeah. Yeah, but the difference there is that your wife, how old was she when you met her?
22.
Yeah, she was a kid.
Yeah.
You met Dane. When did you guys get together? Just a couple of years ago.
I was 25.
25.
That's when I met him, but we got together when I was 26.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't think you'll wake up from it then. I think you guys will be fine.
Yeah, I'm really looking forward to Leslie on the cam said dirty 30s are the best years.
She keeps waiting for him.
I'm waiting every day. I'm waiting to wake up, and all of a sudden, my whole life's going to be dirty. I'm just waiting for it.
Just wait. There's an awakening.
I don't know. We'll see. I just don't even want to pay attention to it, to be honest.
What do you want us to do? Like, what are we supposed to ignore it, or are we supposed to do something?
You want me to be completely honest?
Yeah.
I'm going to tell you. I don't want you to do anything. Don't make a big deal about it. But if you do nothing for my birthday, I will not be pleased.
All right.
Does that make sense?
Yeah, well, yeah. Balloons and stuff like that, probably.
I don't know if I care about balloons.
Well, what do you want us to do?
I don't know. Could be creative. I don't know.
He's going to write a song. Is that good enough?
Are you?
Why would you? Why you told her that before, too. Why would you tell her that?
She doesn't know what it is.
So, but like, why?
Aw, that's so sweet.
Because I want to put pressure on you. Start working on it.
Well, maybe I'm not going to write one at all now because you let the cat out the bag. Now I got to come up with a different
present. Why do I get punished for him, his stupidity?
I don't know.
That's not fair.
I know.
You know how radio works. We have to promote things, man. We can't just let something happen.
Sure we can.
No, you cannot.
We did when I've written a song for you for your birthday. Because it's a present. It's supposed to be a surprise what your gift is.
I know what I want now. I just realized. I want Botox. Someone buy me Botox.
Can we inject it?
With the assistance of a medical professional, I would let you.
Maybe. Let me see what we can work out.
In my forehead. Just right here in these lines.
Now, you say that. If I go up to sales, say we need a vial of Botox.
I don't want a vial. I want to make sure. I don't want to just do one Botox. I want it to look normal. I don't want to have just one wrinkle gone.
You know I have.
Yes, I do. I got
some forehead wrinkles.
Yes, I do have some up there. And they're getting worse. And I just have a feeling I'm like getting stressed because I only have a week. And then I'm going to wake up when I'm 30 and it's just going to be like crow's feet, everything. God, no. Yeah.
We'll figure it out. Johanna turning 30 next week. There's no song, by the way. I was just joking on that.
Oh, okay. Oh, no. No song.
No song. Sorry about that.
Darn it. Mm. I was really thought so.
The Tracy's Collision Cam is live on YouTube. Woo! Frog Mornings on YouTube. Gary Nelson and Johanna.
Says keep her off what's in the box.
No.
Ooh.
Yes, he can't.
That's your turn next week, ain't it?
You're one of the lucky ones. Why, Johanna? It'll only be the last few. Dang, in the 40s.
Yes, Becky, I do want to go with you. I would go with you.
Where?
She's going to... I can't say that. I'm not even going to try to say that word.
Punta Cana.
I really do want Botox.
You don't need it. You really do not need it.
I don't care. I want it.
You're supposed to start before you need it.
Don't get the lips done, though.
Why?
We know a mutual person who got it done. It's the upper lip, I think. It's the upper lip is I have problems with.
Like this?
It's just
looks like
much.
A cat or something. I got it.
And they think it looks good. I just don't understand.
Well, some people it does look good.
No, it does not.
If
I've
you
never
do just
seen
little
it.
Bits, baby babies.
Yeah, but I thought that it never goes away. Like it stays in your body, but like shifts to another place.
I've heard that before. I don't know. I haven't done enough research. Hello, honey. Can you hear me? Hi. Can you just put it like I don't know in the bedroom or something? I just don't want
to 50.
Out
then 30 doesn't look so
children.
Bad. Hmm? Wait till you're close to 50, says Becky. Then 30 doesn't look so bad.
Okay. I'd take 30 like that. I'd take 30 like that.
So would I.
You would.
Yes.
Why? What would you do different?
I don't know what I would do different, but I would do things differently.
In what way? What way?
I don't know.
You don't have one?
No, I don't have one. No, I don't. Not one that I want to go into.
Why?
It's because I don't want to go. I don't want to.
We got time to fill.
I'm sure we do.
What are you wanting to talk about?
No, he wants me to talk about what I would do differently if I could go back 30.
I don't think I got that line.
What would you do
different? Joanne, if you go back to 20, what would you do?
I don't like living in life that way, first of all.
Fun little exercise, right?
I don't know.
It's hard to say, isn't it? You got a couple of kids now. So anything you go back in time and change, then that screws that up.
I don't have an issue thinking of life before my kids or life without my kids. Like, I obviously love my kids, and I would never trade them for the world. But, I mean, you can still play out a scenario. I don't know. Because, like, there's a lot of things that I thought that I wanted in my early 20s that now, like, looking back, I'm like, why did I want any of that? Like, yeah. I don't want any of that. I would have maybe traveled more. I think that would be my biggest thing. I wish I would have gone to more places.
That's hard to do, though, when you were in your 20s. You don't have any money.
That's the problem. It's, like, such a sucky thing because you don't have any money, but you're so available and free to do it.
Yeah. Life is definitely backwards.
It's so backwards.
Yeah.
So you have to wait until you're empty nester and you can do whatever you want.
Until you're you.
Well, is it not true? Once your kids leave, it's true. Like, then you can do whatever you want, and that's you're finally fine. Financially stable enough to do it.
I'm still working on that.
Like, but there's a piece, too, of, like, there's something fun about being single and going somewhere. Like, that was the most fun for me. Like, not having any attachments and being able to just, like, go anywhere I wanted.
Did you ever hitchhike?
Yeah, I used to hitchhike. Oh, that's how I got around in Hawaii. That's the only way I got around.
Did you do the thumb?
Yeah, I did.
You did the thumb?
Yeah, but it was like, it's not up. It's like side down. It's like weird. I don't know.
Why would you do it side down?
It's not side down. It's just like down at the side. It's
you
not like
do this?
It's not like.
Where did that originate, the thumb?
I don't know.
With hitchhiking. But you would just do it, like, down by your leg.
Like, as
hidden,
I was walking.
Like a hidden
like a secret signal, one. Like a secret signal. But a lot of people did in there, and it wasn't as scary. Like, I would never do it here.
You think it's
you get
scarier
picked up
here?
Yes. Yes. And maybe also, you're on an island. Like, it's not like they can take you, like,
take you to a cave or something?
Yeah.
Yeah, I guess, but it just seems more safe.
God, can't kill me. We're on an island.
I don't know. I was risky. I will say I was a risky person. Mm. I'm not anymore.
I've never hitchhiked, never picked one up.
Mm-mm.
I tried picking one up one time.
You tried picking one up?
Where, here?
Yeah.
Oh, that's dangerous here. You get stabbed here.
Would he not get in?
He's like... This lady's got, I'm like, welcome. Come in my car. I was like too willing, you know.
I think if I had a truck, maybe I'd put him in the back. Is that rude?
Like, yeah, in it's the rude and illegal, I think.
Why?
Can I ride in the pickup bed?
We used to do it all the time.
Yeah.
When? In the 80s?
I used to ride in the pickup bed all the time.
Again, when? I don't think that's legal.
I wasn't born in the 80s.
If you got that wheel, that little hump, that's when you got the good seat, man.
Yeah, that's right.
Sometimes we put lawn chairs back there.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, we always rode around in the back truck.
Oh, well, I mean, dog bounty hunter started in white.
That's there. Good, Javi. If I could go back, I'd spend more time with my mom. She passed at 36 when she was 16.
What? Who's this?
What? Hello there and good morning. JP and Friends Talk Show?
Yeah.
I don't know. But that sounds like it's in my show. When I was Johanna Perkins. You guys are. Uh-huh.
TV show.
It's illegal. We used to do it when I was a kid. Small town living. We used to always ride around the back of the truck. Yeah.
They said See? It's illegal?
Yeah, I think it is illegal, but. Is it plus friends or and friends?
And friends. JP and Friends Talk Show.
Is it a real person?
No idea.
If I had to guess, it's another iMichelin.
Oh, I would say yes.
You think it is?
Yeah, one person likes it. Two people follow it.
No. Okay. Anyway. Check out is our Facebook like nope. I used to sleep in the transmission hump of my grandparents' old car going to Iowa. What? You know, that was a thing. I did not know.
I did not know.
Such a good singer. So good.
Me?
Yeah, the best I ever heard.
Thank you.
Number one. Number one to me.
I'm just laughing at the JP and Friends talk show.
Guys.
Gary. What?
Had a good run, guys.
Stop. Why do you do that?
We have. Have we not had a good run?
No.
Don't mean the run's over, does it?
No, we have not had a good run. I don't think so. I think we're just starting to run.
You think the running has just begun?
I think so.
Nelson, I think running's just begun.
All right.
Where do you want to duke this out? Running for a little while.
When, where?
What's that?
Time and place. Let's go. Let's go.
What?
You saying fighting words.
I would not want to fight you. Not in a word fight.
But a strong fight, yes.
I probably would win in a strong fight.
Probably.
Not in a word fight, I wouldn't. I'd be scared.
I'd probably eat you alive a little bit.
I'd have to let you lead it, because I don't know how far we can go with it.
With what?
The words.
That sounds like then you think you could beat me.
No, that's not it. No, I don't think I could win.
But you're saying that you would go further than me, so you'd want me to set the precedent?
Like, I'm not saying I'd go further than you. I would see how far you would go.
Well, probably too far.
You would go too far? Then I would go too far, too. We'd go too far together. Over from the night before. Turn it right into a smile real quick. It might take one or it might take six.
Join the Cam Fam and listen on YouTube. Gary, Nelson, and Johanna are live on the Tracy's Collision Cam. Head over to YouTube and search Frog Mornings. Froggy 98.
Another one of Camp's keywords coming up at 12:30 today. 12:30, be listening with Advanced Medical Imaging. When you get the keyword, go to our website and enter it, and you could be going to see Ohio State and the Huskers on Saturday, 11 a.m. kickoff. Nelson and Johanna, the host of this week's tailgate party.
Yeah.
In between Brewskis and Buzzer Billy's, 8 o'clock, it'll start Saturday morning. Grab breakfast and a beer or whatever. And get ready for a big game on Saturday. If you missed it, Amar, tomorrow morning, Amar will be on the show for Why Am I Still Single with Michael Tisch Jewelers. Things are looking up for our guy, Amar. 2 weeks in a row, ladies have said, I want to meet him. We don't know what's going on here.
Gosh, it's like the season of Amar or something, you know?
Finally. He was so excited when we broke the news to him this morning. Could not wipe the smile off his face. He's going to be on the show tomorrow with a woman. He'll be blindfolded. She won't, because she already knows what he looks like.
Mm-hmm.
He's guaranteed to say hot.
Yeah, there's nothing that could go wrong, I think, on the date that would make him say
you hot. You say, no, you know what? You say that. But we had hooked him up with someone when we used the word help as the help word. Remember that?
Yeah.
And the help word was because he didn't want to. He was supposed to say it if he was wanted out of the situation, like he didn't want to date that person.
Yeah, but wasn't that a real mismatch that we were trying to kind of force?
Because and you really don't know if this is a mismatch or not. How do you know?
I thought that one was a mismatch from the beginning.
Okay, that's fair. That's fair.
What the place I'm coming from.
You've done the booking on the one for tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
Do you think it's a match?
Yeah, just based on what information I have about that person and what I have snooped on Facebook.
And maybe his past dating experience, Amar's.
Mm-hmm.
Somebody else that he met on the show, they dated for a while.
Yeah.
Like, I think it's going to be good for him tomorrow.
Yes.
I think it's going to be great. I'm so excited.
Don't miss it. Amar will be on the show tomorrow with Why Am I Still Single. Just curious about Friday's what's in the box, too, if we could. If we have a minute here.
I made some calls, and I think I have something.
Oh, nice.
You're going to be in the lead on this one?
Well, as of right now, I am, if he thinks it's a good idea. You can go with me to go get it.
Okay, I will.
Okay. After the show?
Yeah, you want to go today and get it?
Are you going to go to our place?
No. That's our place.
Do you guys have a place?
We're going to have a place after
Apparently,
today.
Apparently, we're going to have a place.
After today, we're going to have a place.
Can I tell you, I don't want to get into this too much.
What?
Our place.
Our place?
You're in my place.
Yeah, our place.
Where we have picked up product.
I feel like we have established a story there somehow. Like, I feel like they probably talk about us.
There's a language barrier at this place we go to.
But there has to be an assumption of why we're there.
Right. They know why we're there.
Maybe.
There's no way that they listen, but they understand why we're in the store.
To some capacity. Or they think we got some real weird kink going on with the crap that we're buying.
Could be kink. I didn't think about that.
Yeah.
Didn't think about kink.
Yeah.
They're giving us ideas of other things.
Oh, yeah.
Walking us around the store. We can't even, there's no
but
language.
There's no
we
language.
Can't, we can't
They're
talk.
Just showing us things.
Yeah.
That's great.
Oh, it's wonderful.
It's beautiful. Yeah.
You know what's the best part? Never mind. I can't tell it. Never mind.
Why?
I just can't tell it because it might give something away. But
in a future, future things?
Yeah.
Yeah.
But anyway, yeah. Yeah. We'll see what you think about it.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know. Yeah, I don't know. I want it to be good enough. And from what was described to me, sounded like it would be good enough.
Okay.
Does that make sense?
Yeah.
But I'm scared that I'll see it in person and say it's not good enough.
Like we need more layers?
Yeah. But I already thought of a layer.
I have an idea about like layer stuff too, but I don't, not necessarily a main idea. I got like layer ideas.
Okay.
That'll be Friday, what's in the box with John Henry's. We don't know. My hands are going in. I won't know what's in it. I'll be put into another room, and you guys will surprise me. Something you want to watch. If you didn't catch last week's, you can go back and watch that one still. And I just want to clarify, there is a picture of Johanna and Nelson floating around there, around the internet.
Yeah, is it clear what that is on my head?
He's wearing the stomach on his head.
I tried to stretch it out to see if it would go over
my head. I love that picture. It's it's like a really good picture of me, so I really like it. But then I'm next to him, and he has a stomach on his head.
Since TV isn't an option for them, join them on the Tracy's Collision.
My arm keeps going numb on here. Hands or pinkies?
Oh!
I'd probably go hands on this one. God, my hand keeps itching in here.
Is your thumb?
Yeah.
I know.
You still got the itchies?
No, I feel good today. Don't say it, because now I'm about to start itching.
You got the itchies?
Well, I went crazy on my lips, and I think I broke them.
Oh, no. You should have seen this girl's lips yesterday. I've never seen anything like it before.
Now they're just, like, really red.
I bet they're so sensitive. Lips are sensitive. That's a sensitive area.
Would you see how hard I was scrubbing them?
I saw you went about. You went under.
I think I like pulled off so much layers of skin. Like it's like really.
Oh my God. Oh.
It's been a good run, guys.
The Tonight Show has a bit called What's in the Box.
Never heard of it. Gary, itchy hands can be a sign of a problem with your kidney or liver.
Don't you dare. What if it's just one itchy hand?
it's
just an itchy thumb.
Did you guys see where they are coming out with a blood test where they can detect like 100 different cancers?
No, I
whatever.
Didn't.
I'll believe it when I see it. That's also why that one woman, that billionaire, is on
Elizabeth.
Yeah,
whatever.
Holman or
because she said she could do that, and they even went so far as to put like stations into Walgreens.
Right, and like people
was
were
alive.
They were
the
duping
machine
people.
Was
all I know
a
is
lie.
The test is available at Mayo Clinics.
Oh,
yeah, but this was this Theranos was available at major clinics too.
Like, I didn't say major, I said Mayo.
Well, would you consider the Mayo Clinic a major clinic?
I would say that it is the clinic.
Mm.
And I wouldn't think that they have stuff there that would not be legit.
But if they're getting, what I'm saying is, if they're getting false test results, She was they were falsifying results.
Wow. I don't know. All I know is it hasn't been approved by the FDA. And insurance has to pay for it, and it's about $1,000. But the thing is, do you want to know?
That yeah, you want to know.
Not that you currently have cancer, but you could have it in the future.
Then, yeah, I would want to know that, too.
Living with it? What if it's one that you can't cure?
I feel like you could always have cancer.
No, I just want just I just want the curable ones. Where's she going? She's just doing walk around.
She's just doing walk off.
That's okay. I feel like doing walk around too sometimes. I hear you. Me too. What do you think, Nelson?
Yeah, sometimes I go potty, not for a full walk around, but yeah, that's yeah, nice. You get just up go and move.
Point A to B, B to A, A to B, B to A.
I thought you said point A to P.
I did too.
That would have been funny. That would have been funny.
A to P would have been really funny.
I'm going to give him credit for it anyway.
I can't get it. I can't accept it.
Well,
why not?
Can't accept it. That's why we are here, guys. You know what I mean? Because we cannot do those jokes on the spot, at least not me.
Yes, you can.
I didn't. It was right there in front of me, and I did A to B. That's okay. My brother,
I don't know what.
Huh? Heather... I don't know. I'm kind of scared to ask him.
You're scared? Yeah, hobby.
I love when you do that. Just out of nowhere. What do you love about her, Nelson?
About who? About Johanna?
Yeah. Give her a gift. Give her a verbal gift here.
I love her intelligence because it's nice. Why is that not nice? Let me build on it.
I said that's nice. That's nice.
Yeah, he said it's not nice.
Why?
He said that's not nice. Because your intelligence, it feeds all of your best aspects of your life, which especially your comedy. You're very sharp and you're very quick. I've said this before, and you guys think I'm joking. It's intimidating to work with you.
Mm-hmm. It wasn't at first.
No, I don't think I was good at
first. You showed that video to me, remember?
What, I did? Oh, yeah. Yes.
He was not intimidated in that video, was he not?
No, he was
He thought he was king in that video.
How do you know that that's not just me lashing out because it is so intimidating to work with her?
No, there's... okay, well, let me ask you. Were you intimidated in the beginning?
She's been funny for a long time, yeah.
That's so, not the
as
answer.
As long as I can remember, yes, I have been... first, it was not intimidated. It was... what's the word I'm looking for? Like, not hurt by it, but... I don't know, dominated by it, so it upset me.
Ooh, I like it.
From the gate, out of the gate.
Yeah.
See, I don't think so, because out of the gate, she was, you know.
Not good, to say it.
No, you were not what you are today.
I wasn't
for
sure.
You weren't comfortable. You were confused. We did not teach you well.
No, you didn't. You just put a microphone in front of my face and never told me anything that was going on.
That's how we do it around here.
Yeah.
Best way.
Sink or swim. You swam. First, you drowned a little bit.
No, I didn't. Yeah. I just swallowed
some
floated.
Water. You
floated on my back.
Water.
I floated on my back.
Not
I didn't
first.
Do anything. I just floated. I wasn't swimming. I wasn't making waves. I wasn't doing nothing. I was just sitting there.
What was this man doing? Got you by the shoulders. I'm pushing down. I said, let her come up. Let her come up. Pool ain't big enough for all of us. I said, yes, it is. Let the girl swim.
Oh.
Next thing I know, you're diving. You're doing all kind of triple.
Doing tricks.
Somersaults.
That's so nice.
Pushed you to be better. Y'all bring out good qualities in each other. That's what we say, Tara.
And bad. We bring out a lot in each other.
Where did you sip at on the cup? Do you remember?
I don't.
I don't know that we bring out the worst.
I'll say this to you. I was like, I realized what I was doing mm-hmm. at like this point.
So you grazed. It was a graze job there.
And I think I barely touched my lip on the my bottom lip on it. Yeah, I'm drinking out of a juice box.
Sometimes you got to drink out of juice box.
I just don't have... I like the juice, okay? And it doesn't come in a big bottle. And it's... I buy it for my kids. Anymore. I know. It's like starting to make me sick, so I have to drink the juice.
It's so delicious, but so potent.
He went and got a chicken sandwich. He didn't even ask you yesterday.
I was right behind him.
Who?
Oh, shut up.
We just talked about that.
He's right behind me.
He caught me.
He caught you. You caught him. You caught each other.
No, he caught me. He caught me. I did not catch him. He called me. And I asked him, picking
you?
Up, like,
that's all
behind
me.
Him, like directly behind him. Wasn't even paying attention.
To we went to Popeyes, got the Popeyes chicken sandwich.
That's funny.
There's a Popeyes right there by that Hy-Vee we were at. So I pull in, I make my order, and then he calls me. I was like, what is Gary calling me for? And I look and see it's, I say that, what is Gary calling me for? And as I'm putting the phone up to my face, I lock eyes with him in his rearview mirror.
Oh, that's so cute.
He's getting the chicken
that's
sandwich.
Adorable.
Yeah, I saw him filling up your bag, your big old soda. I saw it all. Getting ready, man.
They don't know me at that one.
I was just going to say.
They only know me at 48th.
What were you just going to say?
I can't believe he went there. I can see him driving all the way at the other one because they know him. They know his order.
Yeah.
Which one knows your order? The one closest
right
to us?
The
one that we went to?
Uh-huh.
Oh. I tried going in.
I go there so much. So stupid. I go there so much. If I see that there's like five cars or whatever in the drive-thru,
yeah,
and I go in.
You couldn't go in when we went there.
I'll go inside and I will get preferential treatment. So like I skip cars in the line. They see me like as soon as, especially this one woman that works there, she sees me and then she starts making my sandwich. You gotta take care of the regulars, man.
Yeah, I sure do.
You're paying their bills for sure. What if you knew how much what? What's wrong?
Nothing. We'll find out how much what.
What's wrong?
I don't know. He did like
I just slapped my leg.
I know, but and then you did the
something like, Happy does. We'll talk about on cam.
Oh. No, there's nothing.
Okay, I just read it wrong. Sorry.
I'm just reading Sam's comment about chicken.
Listen, I'm hypersensitive to people's emotions. I can't help it. I'm just that kind of person.
I don't know, Heather. They should have pitched me for Popeyes a long time ago.
Yeah, when have they not? Why?
Because
they
he was with Wendy's. He's the Wendy's guy. He's done all the fast foods.
Yeah.
Not Cane's.
Nope, not Cane's. Wasn't good enough for Cane's.
That's mine. That's mine all the way. Wasn't it so cute, that picture I sent you guys? My kids literally took that dog and said, Mommy, can we watch the iPad? They weren't watching the iPad. I let them watch the iPad because it was the cutest thing. They go, can we watch the iPad with the puppy? I was like, sure. And they put it in the seat.
Are they still buddies with it?
Yes. I'll show you a little video later. But
yeah.
Frankie at first was scared.
Oh, he's a little scared.
I think he was disappointed in the prize for a second.
In the what?
I said, I got you a prize, and I pulled it out, and he goes...
Oh. Collision Cam is live. Facebook.com/Froggy981.
We talked about this now a couple of times, and people are busting us out a little bit, calling us out. We said that we were going to reveal the identity of earrings. I think we said that a couple of weeks ago. I have not. We've mentioned it to him, but we don't know for sure. Kyle has given me the nod. Kyle, do you have news on this?
Well, Earrings walks in here before he gets into his office every day.
Yeah.
Let's see. And I asked him, I said, Earrings, we need to reveal your identity. Are you okay with that? He said, yes. So I said, I will talk to you guys after the show, figure out the details.
Okay.
Here's the thing.
And then I also asked, would he be open to meeting some of our listeners?
Oh, Donald wants a piece of them.
Who just want to express their feelings about the show.
Uh-huh.
He said, okay.
Ooh.
He caught him in a good mood today.
Yeah, I think so. They had budget talks yesterday, and he said that went well, and so...
Oh, well, can you tell us about that? Are we getting the lights in here and stuff?
Oh, that was not part of the... We're on track, you know?
So, no. What do you mean budget went well?
Well, they just, you know, hey, this is where we're headed. This is where we're going. This is what next year is going to look like.
Okay.
They said, okay, cool.
Well, this is what we need to do. So he said, yes, he'll come on and reveal his identity.
Yeah, we just got to figure out when.
Friday.
Okay.
And yes, he will let listeners come on and talk to him.
Friday?
Yeah. Okay. We'll do it before we get into what's in the box.
It's going to be so early.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, we can do it after 8. I don't care.
I just don't know what your plan is to do with him, mm-hmm. I guess.
The plan first is to reveal who he is, what he looks like. So when you see this guy at Hy-Vee, you go up to him and say something to him.
Well, you're not going to do anything fun with it? Like...
Listen, this is open forum, what?
I don't know. I don't know. I'm not the ideas guy. You are. No, I just figured you'd have an idea.
No.
Like something like letting Donald talk to him or something like that.
Yes. That was my idea.
It's an uncomfortable one. That one.
My favorite.
I know. And I think it's really good.
We can have him do what's in the box.
No, we can't have him do it. Then we have to wait till next week.
Why? Let me in on it.
Do you have a good idea?
Let me in on it.
Do you have a good idea to put in the box for him?
For him? Right.
You know we have things.
Yeah, we do.
I mean, we could do that.
I'm willing to talk about it, but then you're getting pushed to next week.
It's not a skip job.
Okay, now wait a minute. That's not a bad idea because next week is your birthday. We shouldn't have you do what's in the box on your birthday.
My birthday's next week. I keep forgetting.
Yeah.
Yeah, I shouldn't do what's in the box
for
my birthday.
But that is only if, and listen, Earrings is right now, for some reason, he's a huge fan of yours.
Mm-hmm.
So the only way this deal works where you don't have to do it your birthday week is if he agrees to do it on Friday.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Okay. If he doesn't agree, then I'm still on Friday and you're still next week.
That's not nice.
Oh, I know, but that's just the way it is. I mean, we can't change.
Yes, we can.
How? Unless Nelson wants to do it next week for you.
Oh, I thought you guys had like a celebration plan for me.
We do.
Does sound like it.
But it's still your week to put your hands in the box. So anyway, Friday, Earrings. Kyle says yes, he's agreeing to this. We have to make sure that he can do it on Friday. And then we're going to get a couple of listeners that will come on Zoom, and they're going to have one-on-one with Earrings. We're going to have a list of things we need to feed them to ask about, the lights and those types of things.
Sure.
And we'll sig Donald on him. And he's okay with that, Kyle, you said.
Yeah. I didn't say sick Donald on him. I sold it.
But you don't tell them all everything. Sure.
We're going to have to, maybe what we can do tomorrow is bring Donald on and work with him, coach him up a bit. I think what he needs to do probably is say nice things about Earrings at first and then lay into him right after that. And then butter up again. Right? Is that how you do that?
Yeah. Yeah.
I don't feel like you guys are on board with this.
I'm on board for him putting his hands in the box. I think that's more interesting than sticking Donald on him.
Okay.
Personally, once you put that on the table, but then you run the risk of him being a Kyle.
That's why I was just going to say.
Never mind.
That's
You're
why
right.
I've been. Yeah.
They're one and the same.
I just don't know if he'll be scared enough for it to be interesting.
Yeah.
But maybe it'd be funny because I can see him just like going in and squeezing whatever it is.
And then
let's give him something to squeeze.
Yeah.
Right?
Just give him something to squeeze.
We got some stuff.
Oh, we do. We do.
Yeah, but again, do you want to waste something like that on what could possibly be the same reaction you're going to get from me?
No.
We don't know.
He's a tough guy.
I don't know. We're going to have to talk about it.
Maybe it allows us to put in something that would be too far to put in the box for the three of us.
This would be your chance to get back at him. Nelly?
Why am I getting back at him? Don't put that narrative out that I have any reason to get back at him.
That's not a narrative I'm putting out there.
It already exists.
Yeah, that's what he's saying.
It already exists.
No, it does not.
It's already a story written, man.
No, it does not. Unwrite that story.
You can't. What's out there?
Yeah, it's not been printed to any pages.
We'll figure it out, but we will be revealing the identity of our boss, who has wanted us to keep it a secret now for 2 years. No voice, no video. It's been excluded. We can only say his name, Earrings. That is going to change this week.
Nelson is desperately trying to go viral, and you can help. Watch the Tracy's Collision Cam on YouTube. Just search.
Yeah, I don't like the what's in the box now because it's going to be lame. I didn't think about that.
I mean, unless we thought of something like really, really good, you know?
There you go, Kyle. Yeah.
Why don't we have a mini roast?
Mini roast.
Oh, that's a lot of work.
Well, we just, all we have to do is put CamFam members in the waiting room and then everybody gets 30 seconds.
I'm liking that. Now we are relying on the listeners to have good material. And I know some will.
But that's why you only give them 30 seconds.
Some won't.
So if it's not good.
Yeah, that's not a bad idea.
That's a more efficient use of listeners.
Certainly.
Certainly.
It is.
I know. Thirty seconds in heaven?
Yeah.
We don't know him well enough to have material.
Sounds like a cop out.
No, it's not though. Completely. I mean, what do they know?
Only thing other than right, that's it. Yeah. Yeah, that's true.
But it could all be like show related. It doesn't have to be personal.
I know, but
we don't want personal attacks.
Yes, we do. Those are the funniest ones.
Yeah. I don't know that he has feelings.
I don't either.
He has been in radio a long time.
Yeah.
He is rock station type guy.
Yeah, he's a rocker.
You know what I mean? Like, mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like, I don't see him doing St. Jude marathon stuff. I mean, he has before.
So. Yeah, he can.
But
he
you
can
know
pull
what I mean?
Off.
He can pull it off, but yeah. It's not like, I wouldn't be like, that's the voice.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
You know?
If you were to see him, and you will, you'll understand what we're saying.
Yes.
But at the same time, I've got to be honest, I like him. Like,
oh, yeah.
I can't say that I always have, because I haven't. But
I say he's the best I've ever had.
He is?
Well, manager-wise.
Yeah.
I've only had two, so don't tell him that.
I've had a bunch, and the worst one that I've ever had still works in this town.
Oh, for real?
Yeah.
Ooh, I want the tea. Spill the tea later.
Hmm?
Do you know what that means?
Spill the tea?
Yeah, do you know what that means?
Yes.
What does it mean?
Oh, my God.
What does it mean?
So stupid.
No, what does it mean, though?
Give me the details.
Okay. Kind of. I mean, mostly,
spill
yeah.
Spill the tea. Give me the trash. Talk
there
to the trash.
Yeah, there you go. There more you go. Like that.
The gossip.
Yeah. The gossip.
Yeah, girl, I'm right there, you know.
I don't know if you...
You see that disconnected, but we're not disconnected, Kyle? I wonder why that is.
This is about to be a Michael Scott / David Wallace situation.
You don't watch The Office,
I think that's why I disconnected the, I that one day.
I've seen every episode of The Office.
Have you really?
Yes.
Uh-huh.
It's because
what's
his name?
It started showing
what's
that
the
era.
Main guy's name?
But we're obviously still broadcasting.
Steve Carell?
No, the other main guy.
Jim?
It
I haven't seen any comment. Like,
well, that's there's 30 more
his
comments
humor?
After Carissa's
yeah.
comment.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because that's what I was kind of going side by side here. So I wonder why that is.
Can you talk to him? Yeah.
Whatever, it's still going.
This is...
Okay. Sure. I'll get it in.
I did not know what happened to the one in... What?
C-thread.
Oh, the process. You guys are so funny.
Wow,
that is hilarious. You guys, remember, it's in Carney. What the heck? I love you guys. I feel like people on the cam know me better than people in my life. I'm not kidding you. I'm not kidding. That's so funny. Good question, says Heather. That is a good question. What did happen with that situation? Did we get it?
We got a different processor.
That's broken, isn't it?
No, it's hooked
I thought
up.
It
no.
was broken. I thought Gear Bear said it. Oh,
what?
What was I gonna call him? Sparkles.
Sparkles.
Is that what it was? I need a new nickname for Gary.
She talked to Nelson.
I looked up, I Googled what nicknames for the name Gary is, and the first one that came up was Gaz. G-A-Z. Isn't that terrible?
What's this, what?
Gaz.
Gaz?
G-A-Z.
For a nickname for me?
That's, I just Googled nicknames for Gary, and it said
Gaz.
Like,
that's terrible.
It's so bad. It's so bad.
Mm. Yeah, I don't like that too much.
I don't either.
I just like normal nicknames, you know what I mean?
Like what? There's nothing now.
Yes, there is. Are you saying, did you talk about that? Why are you trying to find a new nickname?
I didn't say why I'm trying to find a new nickname. I just said I need to find a new nickname. Is Gary a good
name? Yes, a processor is kind of still needed too, maybe. I don't know, actually.
Well, I'm Googling nicknames for Gary, and one of the, you know, the options on Google that, like, you can say.
I didn't want to hear it because I just heard you say it. Is Gary a good name?
You want to see, know what it says?
No, it's going to say, no, it isn't.
It says, parents just don't like the name anymore. Gary Gary reached his peak in the U.S. in the early 1950s, when it was at one time the 12th most popular boy name.
Wow.
With more than 38,000 appearing every year.
Almost cracked the top 10.
There were even 90 girls named Gary in 1947.
Oh, my God.
Those poor women.
Mm-hmm.
I had read and I thought long, well, it's been a while ago.
But
the name was going extinct.
I feel like it probably is.
When was the last Gary? Has there anybody on the cam that knows a baby named Gary? I would say no.
Nicknames for Gary. G Money.
Yeah, I've been called G Money.
Care Gare.
Care Gare? No.
Garbage disposal.
Garbage disposal? Garbage disposal. Like that, don't you? I go mostly on my last name. That's where I get all my nicknames.
Green Dog.
Green Dog, double G.
Gary Glitter.
No Gary Glitters.
I love Gary Glitter. Garykins.
You call me what you want to call me.
Gary Johnson. According to a U.S. baby name site, Gary, which means spear.
Baby G.
Has seen a decline over recent decades.
What?
It means spear. That's spear. Native American.
That means spear?
Native American talk.
I'll call you Spear.
What's wrong with Spear? I'll take it. That sounds tough.
Spear?
Spear sounds tough, yes.
In 2013, there were less than 450 boys in the U.S. named Gary.
Wow, you're so unique. How many named
are You can
named
find
Johanna?
A positive on everything. I love it so much. I can't even tell you. What are you going to say?
I said, how many Johannas? I feel like there's like none.
There's a lot of Johannas.
No, there isn't. What? Name one other Johanna you've met.
Gaines.
Joanna.
They're the same.
It's not the same. Princess Gary, the little girl? That's a nickname on here. So for real. Terry? What is Terry? Oh, I'll call you Terry.
That's Terry Gary? No.
That's fun.
Told you I've been called Harry Gary. That's
Greenwood. Woody. Ooh. Should we call you Woody?
That was my dad's nickname, Woody.
Woody, for real?
Greeny, call me Greeny. Greeny, Green Dog, double G, pretty much it.
Double G?
Yeah.
Oh, I get it. I get it now. GG. Oh, I call you GG.
No, that sounds femmy. Woody Spear.
Woody Spear. That's a liar.
It's a good one, Heather.
Okay, I like it. I'm here for it. Woody Spear.
Gearmeister. G Money. I like G Money. Yes, sir. Ma'am, I mean.
No, G Money is too nice.
Little Woody. Why gotta be little?
You say ma'am, but is that Ruth or Ruth? That's not a woman, is it?
I don't know which one it
Ralph?
Is.
No.
Twelve 30, the next. Cam's keyword, Cam Jurgens with the Huskers. If you want to go see the Huskers in Ohio State at 12:30 with Advanced Medical Imaging, we'll have another keyword for you. Enter that at froggy981.com and you could win tickets. Johanna and Nelson will be your hosts this weekend for our tailgate party in between Buzz Billy's and Brewskis. It'll be at 8 o'clock on Saturday, so come on by, have a drink, grab some breakfast, and get ready for the game with, again, that 11 a.m. kickoff, which we are your home of the Huskers. You can catch the game right here on this radio station. It'll be a fun tomorrow, a very fun Why Am I Still Single? Amar is coming on the show.
Mm-hmm.
So glad that this has happened for him. He was scheduled to come on last week. The woman that we had planned got nervous. She's extremely shy and wasn't able to come on. And we felt like maybe we let him down. And then out of nowhere, another woman said, I want to meet him.
Mm-hmm.
We told him, we broke the news this morning to him.
Yeah. And he was smiling.
Oh, I sure hope this. I love that smile. What if this one cancels?
Yeah, that's
gonna be bad. I know. We run the risk of that happening, I guess.
Yeah.
So tomorrow morning, good friend of the show, Amar, will be on. And we'll see if we can find him a girl. I think that other than that, we're done. You guys got anything else?
No.
Johanna, you got anything else?
No, I don't think so.
All right. Well, have a great rest of the day. Enjoy your day. We'll be back tomorrow morning. A bunch of music is coming your way in just a few minutes.
Faces for radio, voices for newspaper. Gary.
Got it?
All right, everybody.
All right.